The Democratic Party establishment has been conspicuously silent in the face of very serious allegations against Joe Biden. However, one finally decided to speak up. But what this individual decided to say isn't too surprising. It was Howard Dean, and he decided to, rather than actually responding to these claims, shoot the messenger, as they say. He tweeted, "This story may or may not be true, but it's from The Intercept, which one, is often not credible, two, was started by Glenn Greenwald, who helped Assange and Putin undermine the 2016 election. I tend to believe victims, but skeptical about sources like this. They are the Fox of the left." Now, first of all, how is The Intercept not credible? How are they less credible than sources that you support, that are either owned by billionaire oligarchs or by large multi-billion dollar corporations? MSNBC is owned by Comcast. The Washington Post is owned by Jeff Bezos. The Intercept was started by an investigative journalist, Glenn Greenwald. Now, I know you don't like Glenn Greenwald, but it's Ryan Grimm who reported on this story and Katie Halper who interviewed Tara Reid. So what about The Intercept do you not like? Like, you can't just throw out a claim like that and try to discredit this organization without explaining specifically why you don't like them. But you see, the thing about Howard Dean is he is a hack. He is currently a lobbyist. He used to be progressive, but now he's a lobbyist. And anytime he has an opportunity to undermine the left, he does it. And it doesn't matter what he said or what the Democratic Party establishment said about Brett Kavanaugh and Christine Blasey Ford. What matters is that their team wins always. So if their team is in a position where it may not look good for their particular players, then they're going to lie, smear, slander, invoke Russian conspiracy theories and how Glenn Greenwald assisted Assange and Russia. I don't even know what that means. I think what he means by that is that The Intercept published articles talking about the WikiLeaks revelations that the DNC rigged the primary against Bernie Sanders that allegedly came from Russia. I don't know what he means by that, but all I know is that this is pathetic. This is sad. The same thing was said about Tara Reid. She was accused of being a Russian asset when she initially accused Joe Biden of sexual assault, which is why she chose to go back into silence. So Democrats don't really have anything left but to trot out Russia, discredit, you know, the organizations that are reporting on stories that they don't like, shoot the messenger, if you will. But it shows you how pathetic they are. It shows you how they stand for absolutely nothing. They have zero integrity. Now, it's sad that I have to criticize Howard Dean because at least he acknowledged the existence of Tara Reid and this story. He at least did that, the bare minimum, right? But everyone else in the Democratic Party establishment has remained silent. Joe Biden has been on MSNBC and CNN multiple times since this story broke, and the number of times he's been asked about Tara Reid, zero. So the mere fact that Howard Dean is even acknowledging the story, I think, is a win in and of itself. But of course, the way that he's responding is predictably pathetic and disgusting. So Howard Dean is a spineless coward. He is the biggest shill. I think he is the perfect representative of the corporate Democratic wing of the party. And, you know, it doesn't matter what they said about Dr. Christine Blasey Ford and Brett Kavanaugh. What matters, as I said, is that their team wins at all costs. It doesn't matter if you look, you know, like you have no integrity, and they don't care about that. But, you know, as much as they want to hide this story away, the minute that the Democratic Party primaries are officially over, I guarantee you, Republicans will make this the number one story in America. And they are a lot more disciplined than Democrats are in messaging. So whatever they want the narrative to be, that's what it's going to be. And they're going to try to get revenge on Democrats who they believe wrongly accused Brett Kavanaugh. But as someone who dislikes Brett Kavanaugh, Donald Trump, and Joe Biden, and the Democratic Party establishment, I can tell you, they're all hypocrites, they're all opportunists, who are all, you know, in politics for self-serving reasons, and none of them give a damn about women. Because they're not consistent, right? Being consistent and actually remaining principled means that sometimes you have to abandon people who are doing things that are contrary to what they say they believe in, right? So yes, you think that Joe Biden has stood up for women throughout his career. I disagree with that. But now you have a very serious allegation, something that the left claimed for years now with the Me Too movement that we should take seriously. We should vet these claims. Joe Biden should call for an investigation. But the fact that that's not happening, it shows you how fake and phony the Democratic Party is. They stand for nothing. They stand for absolutely nothing. And if this doesn't prove that to you, then absolutely nothing will.
Beta male.